So whenever we've been talking about using the Wronskian, we always assumed that we knew the solutions y1 and y2 of the homogeneous. So this, basically the idea is, well, what happens if we don't know the solution? So we're going to start off assuming we do and then show that we didn't actually need to know after all. So say we've got this and it has the solutions y1 and y2. Just like that. Okay, now we define the Wronskian as y1, y2 prime, minus y1 prime, y2. Now, just for fun, because all of this is always for fun, let's take the derivative of the Wronskian. All right, so we've got the little product rule here, y1 prime, y2 prime, plus y1, y2 double prime, minus y1 double prime, y2, plus y1 prime, y2 prime. And obviously, I was like, when people say obviously, it's like, obviously, and you're like, no, not really, but I think this is pretty obvious. If I distribute the negative, then it's like that. So obviously, that means that the Wronskian is prime is equal to, let's see, this thingy and this thingy cancel out. So I have y1, y2 double prime minus y1 double prime, y2. You're like, that's amazing, and stuff. All right, so basically we need formulas for y1 double prime and y2 double prime, which isn't too hard to get because we can just take it from here. We can get that in general, y double prime is equal to negative p y prime minus q y. And we can just plug that in. So I'm going to plug in, let's see, Wronskian is equal to, let's see, how am I want to do this? I'll say y1. Now y2 double prime is going to be that with y2s, so negative p of x y2 prime minus q y2, like that. So that's this for y2, and then minus y2 times y1 double prime. So y1 double prime is basically the same thing. Yay, basically the same thing with ones. Okay, y1 double prime is p y1 prime minus q y1, like that. And we're going to distribute stuff, because why not? Distribute stuff, and I'm going to, this is a minus plus, like that. And if you look, you will see that we have a, thingies cancel out. The thingies with the q's cancel out. So I have y1 qx y2 minus, and I have plus y1 qx y2. So those cancel. And that means that I end up with minus px times the quantity y2 prime minus y1 prime, like that. Well, wait, I missed something. No, the y2 still goes in there. Let me do like 50 steps at once. Let me just do 12 steps at once. How about y1? P of x, y1, y2 prime, plus p of x, y1 prime, y2. Okay. So let's factor out a negative p. And I end up with y1, y2 prime. Do it like this. Okay. Y1, y2 prime minus y1 prime, y2. And if you're super awesome, you're going to look at this and you're going to go, oh my goodness, this is crazy. This is the Wronskian. Okay. So basically what you end up with is Wronskian prime is equal to negative px times the Wronskian, which is fantastic because it means that you can solve for the Wronskian. Because this is just what we do. Thingy with a minus px dx. Integrate. Dx plus c. And so the integration fairy. I guess it could be a fairy. There, integration fairy. We'll make these wings. Now it looks like kind of like an integration flower. Anyway, integration flower theory says that we'll have something that looks like this. And you're like, where'd the W not come from? All right, I'll call it a C. I'll call it a C, but basically every time we've done stuff like this before, we've realized that that C is just the initial condition. So look, we've got a really cool idea for the Wronskian. So we basically have two different definitions now for the Wronskian, is if I know an initial condition for the Wronskian. So basically if I know an initial condition for Y1, Y1 prime, Y2, and Y2 prime, initial conditions, then I can actually go through here and calculate stuff, calculate Wronskian stuff from there. And I can do that. I'm going to do another video or actually do like applications of all this. But this is really cool. So we can kind of get started off with this. Let me show you one more strategy with the same information. And this one's kind of cool too. So one more strategy. Is again, we've got our standard second order, linear, ordinary, differential, homogeneous equation. And let's say we know that Y1 is a solution, but we don't know Y2. So one thing we can do, and we've done this a lot actually, is we're gonna guess a Y2 is a solution as being U, some unknown function U times Y1, right? So at this point, you should be pretty comfortable with doing stuff like this over and over again. We're going to find the derivative. And the double derivative. Actually, we don't even need to do that. We just need to find the derivative. Just the derivative. We don't need the double derivative. Because we know that the Wronskian, which is this, y1, y2 prime, minus 1 prime y2, is equal to some unknown initial something, this thingy, like this, okay? So we know y1, and everywhere I see y2 prime, I'm gonna put in y2 prime, and everywhere I see y2, I'm gonna put in y2. I know, this is crazy, right? So I've got y1 times u prime, y1 plus u, y1 prime, and that's this one, minus y1 prime, times u y1, like that. And that's this one. Doo. And that has to be equal to this guy. Like that. And distribute stuff and whatever. y1 squared plus u y1 prime y1 minus u y1 prime. Oh, look, that goes away. Equals this. These go away. And I end up with this. I'm going to go that u prime is equal to this thingy, px dx, divided by y1 squared. So basically what I can do is I can solve for u if I have a specific, you know, actual functions, solve for u, and then you have y2, which is awesome. And remember, the reason that we care about y2 is we showed that y is going to be some linear combination of y1 and y2. So if I accidentally get y1, but I don't know y2, I can use the Wronskian to find that, assuming that I have all the initial conditions that I need. And a lot of times, you know, in applications, you will. So this is some really, really cool stuff that you can do with this. And they're just different strategies for solving these problems.